TCP is Reliable Transport Layer Protocol. This means that sender application program that delivers a stream of data to TCP relies on TCP to deliver the entire stream to the application program to the receiver in order, without error, and without any part lost or duplicated. TCP uses acknowledgments to confirm the receipt of the data segments. TCP error control includes mechanisms for detecting and resending corrupted segments using checksums, retransmit corrupted or lost segments, storing out of order segments until missing segments arrive, and detecting and discarding duplicate segments. The important thing for error control mechanisms is the retransmissions of the segments. So let's understand how TCP manages retransmission using a retransmission timer in this video. Normally, there is a bidirectional data transfer between two systems. Suppose client TCP sends one segment. The server TCP sends three segments. First, client sends segments with sequence number 1201 to 1400 with acknowledgement number 4001. When the server sends the segment with sequence number 4001 up to 5000 and acknowledgement number 1401. When the client receives the first segment from the server, it does not have any more data to send. It needs to send only X segments. However, the acknowledgement needs to delayed for 500 milliseconds to see if any more segment arrive. When the ACK delaying timer matures, it sends an acknowledgement. This is because the client has no knowledge if other segments are coming. It cannot delay the acknowledgement forever. When the next segment arrives, another ACK delaying timer is set. However, before it matures, the third segment arrives. Now the client does not wait for timer maturity because to prevent unnecessary retransmission, it sends the acknowledgement. We have not shown the retransmission timeout timer because no segment is lost or delayed. We just assume that this timer performs its duty. Now we will see what happens when segment is lost or corrupted. A lost or a corrupted segment is treated the same way by the receiver. A lost segment is discarded somewhere in the network. A corrupted segment is discarded by the receiver itself. Both are considered lost. We are assuming that data transfer is unidirectional. One side is sending, the other receiving. In our scenario, the sender sends segment 1 and 2, which are acknowledged immediately by an ACK. Segment 3, however, is lost. The receiver receives segment 4, which is out of order. The receiver stores the data in the segments in its buffer, but leaves a gap to indicate that there is no continuity in the data. The receiver immediately sends an acknowledgement to the sender, displaying the next byte it expects. Not that the receiver stores byte 800.1.2.900, but never delivers these bytes to the application until the gap is filled. The sender TCP keeps one RTO timer for whole period of connection. When the third segment times out, the sending TCP resend segment 3, which arrives this time and is acknowledged properly. Now we will understand fast retransmission, in which client send first and second segment, and when it reaches the server, then server sends acknowledgement. Now the client sends the third segment, which may be lost during transmission. Each time the receiver receives the fourth, fifth, and sixth segments, it triggers an acknowledgement. The sender receives four acknowledgements with the same value. I mean, three duplicate X for the lost segments. Although the timer has not matured, the rule of fast transmissions requires that segment 3, the segments that is expected by all of these duplicate acknowledgments, be resent immediately. And now the timer is restarted. Other possibility is delayed segment due to underlying IP networks. The client TCP resends such segments when it's timeout. When server TCP gets such packets with the same sequence number, it is discarded. The next possibility is the lost acknowledgement. A key advantage of using cumulative acknowledgement is, suppose client get cumulative ACK number 901, a lost acknowledgement with ACK number 701 may not even be noticed by the source TCP. Now suppose the client sends two segments with bytes 501-600. And 601-700 and starts the RTO timer. Now, if acknowledgements of 701 lost, client can wait for ACK up to timer matures. Client resent first segment. When receiver receives duplicate segment, it discards it and resend the last ACK 701 immediately. When the client get ACK of 701, it understands the second segment 601-700 is also reached to the server safely. These are the ways for error control by TCP. I hope you learn a lot from this video. So see you next time with more such exciting videos. Till then, bye bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.